हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गेट स्पेशल एंड वेलकम यू एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो फ्रॉम एनर्जी एंड एनवायरनमेंट। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लाइक नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एनर्जी एंड एनवायरनमेंट इन पास्ट मैनर। सो हियर सर, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूट प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जस्ट टेल मी सर, वट डू यू मीन बाय दिस पोल्यूटेंट्स? पोल्यूटेंट्स आर नथिंग सर, बेसिकली सोर्स ऑफ योर पोल्यूशन। एंड वॉट आर लाइक वेन एवर जस्ट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी, टू टाइप्स आर प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी। इन प्राइमरी इज नथिंग सर, अवर डायरेक्ट सोर्स। एंड सर इन सेकेंडरी सर, आफ्टर लाइक सम रिएक्शन वी आर गेटिंग सम पोल्यूटेंट्स सर, दिस इज जस्ट नॉट योर सेकेंडरी पोल्यूटेंट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल सर, इन प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट्स वेन एवर जस्ट वी आर बर्निंग ए कॉल एंड वी आर गेटिंग सम गैसेज आर देर, एंड दिस इज जस्ट नॉट इज वॉट प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल सर, अवर CO2 इज देर, कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड SO2 इज देर, ऑल्सो सर अवर दिस मेथेन हाइड्रोकार्बन CH4, मेथेन इज वेस्ट एग्जाम्पल, ऑल्सो सर अवर नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड ऑल्सो देर, अवर एक्सेट्रा लाइक सम डिफरेंट गैसेज आर देर, एंड पर्टिकुलेट मैटर्स ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। पर्टिकुलेट मैटर्स आर नथिंग सर, बेसिकली लाइक वेन एवर जस्ट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनी पर्टिकुलेट मैटर, सो दीज आर लाइक स्मॉल पीसेज ऑफ सॉलिड लाइक डस्ट पार्टिकल्स जस्ट इन एयर, सो दीज आर ऑल्सो लाइक डायरेक्ट कंसिडर एज ए लाइक प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट। सो इन सेकेंडरी पोल्यूटेंट इफ यू जस्ट आस्क सर, बेसिकली सम रिएक्शन और लाइक वेन एवर जस्ट अवर प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट मिक्स विथ सम डिफरेंट पार्टिकल और डिफरेंट केमिकल रिएक्शंस आर जस्ट पॉसिबल देयर, एंड वी विल गेट सम डिफरेंट पोल्यूशन सो और पोल्यूटेंट। सो दीज आर लाइक पोल्यूटेंट जस्ट नॉन इज वॉट सेकेंडरी पोल्यूटेंट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल सर, अवर SO2 गैस इज देयर एंड दिस इज जस्ट नॉन इज अवर प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट। दिस वेन इज जस्ट दिस मिक्स विद अवर H2O, इट विल क्रिएट H2SO4 एंड दिस विल क्रिएट सम एक्स्ट्रा अदर पोल्यूशन, सो दिस इज जस्ट नॉन इज अवर सेकेंडरी पोल्यूटेंट। सो इन दिस एग्जाम्पल और इन दिस क्वेश्चन जस्ट देर आस्किंग अबाउट प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट। सो सर, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड, नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड, पर्टिकुलेट मैटर्स ऑल्सो वेरी एग्जाम्पल एंड वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, this is also considered as a primary pollutant, so all three options are going to be correct answer, so option D is just going to be correct answer for this question. Now see the next question, which one of the following is a major difference between food web and food chain. So whenever just we are talking about sir food chain is nothing sir, basically one type of linear structure and sometimes basically it's a cyclic structure. So for example sir, basic food chain is nothing sir, we have producer, after that sir we have consumers are basically our primary consumer, secondary consumer, your tertiary consumer, again some decomposers are there and these decomposers again taken by our producer. So this is like one cycle or food chain is just maintained, so this is just known as what? Food chain. But sir, again like interconnected food chains are there, like this is also connected with this, or this is also connected with this, this connected with other also, means sir this is just known as this complex structure. When you just like interconnected are there, we are talking about sir food web. For example sir, our websites or web, we are just talking web means sir our internet is also like a complex interconnection of all computers worldwide or not. In similar manner, like all our food chains or all our like producer like these consumers are connected each other in complex way, just known as what? Food web. And food chains are nothing sir, basically simple food chain means sir producer consumer, your secondary tertiary consumers, and sir decomposer producer, again this chain is just maintained, this is just known as what? Food chain. And sir, whenever like interconnected systems are there, like different or infinity number of your connections are there, this is just known as what? This is just known as your food web. So this is the basic difference. So just see option A, food chain and food webs are linear pathway. No sir, only food chain just linear pathway. Food chain and food webs are interconnected. No sir, only food webs are interconnected. C option, food chain is a single linear pathway. Yes sir, correct. Food webs is interconnected pathway. So option C is going to be what? Correct answer for this question. So this is like a very very important question, or just we have discussed idea of a food web and food chain. Also like in notes and videos, just we have covered everything, like what is this food structure, what food web, like different energy structures are there, like different pyramids are there. So everything just we have discussed in our notes and videos. Now see next question, aerosol plus solid particles plus liquid particles results in dust, mist, smog or smoke. So first of all just tell me sir, aerosols are nothing sir, basically particles in air. So whenever just we mix with our solid or like sometimes in liquid, it will create some like fire, and this fire is nothing sir, will create what? Smoke. So this is just known as this combination will create what? Smoke. And sir, smoke is nothing sir, whenever this our smoke plus fog will create it, this smoke. this will create smoke. And sir, fog is nothing, sir. Fog is again, sir, whenever just like our aerosol particles are there, they just mix with our water droplets, water drops, and it will create what, sir? Fog. So these are like important information you need to just understand, sir. Any type of questions that they ask, what do you mean by this fog? Fog is nothing, sir, aerosol plus our water drops. Also, sir, whenever just we are talking about smoke, smoke is nothing, sir, basically our smoke plus fog. And whenever this aerosol particles consist with our solid particles or liquid particles, these mix up, fire may be there, and this fire create what? Our smoke. And sir, the best source for smoke is also like our cigarette or burning of like our this wood is also very best example for creating of our smoke. So for this question is also going to be, answer is going to be D. Now see next question. What plans should be make for disposal of solid waste management? Very important question. This is just known as your solid waste management question. And from the solid waste management, this is very, very important concept we are going to discuss here. Already like basic, what do you mean with this solid waste management? Everything just we have discussed. Now, sir, tell me in this question, best way should we make the disposal of solid waste? Best way, sir. First, sir, integrated waste management, recycling of waste management, reducing waste management, use of waste management plan. Which is going to be best plan, sir? This integrated waste management plan is going to be very, very important. Whenever we are talking about integrated waste management plan, this is going to be like all parts, recycling, reducing waste, everything is like combinedly we are doing, means integratedly we are doing. So basically what we are doing, we are collecting our best products. Then, sir, we are processing our best products. Or then, sir, we will go for our recycling or what resource recovery is also there. So this is just known as your recycling or resource recovery. And finally, sir, we go for our disposal. So this is like a main planning of our integrated waste management. Means, sir, we will collect, we will process, then, sir, recycle, or basically resource recovery. And finally, sir, we are going for disposal. So what is strategy behind this integrated waste management plan? Sir, what happened? Very important, three strategies for this integrated waste management plan. And this is going to be very, very helpful for your exam. First of all, just first strategy is just known as your source reduction. Source reduction means, sir, from this plan we are talking about, at the source side, whenever just we are creating any product or project, we should reduce this environmental like cause or like pollutants, we should reduce from our source side. So this is also a very good step. Then we will go for our recycle product or recycling. Recycling is also very important. Whenever just we are talking about, sir, some products are there and some waste products are there, we need to use them. Reusable things are there, recycle should be there. And sir, some products like not recyclable, then sir, we will dispose them. So this is the best process, or this is the best methods of integrated waste management. So for this question, sir, answer is going to be A, integrated waste management plan. And sir, what are the process for this IWMP? Collecting, processing, recycling, and disposal. And what are the main advantages, sir? We can just do our source reduction, we can go for our recycling process, and finally, if something is not possible, some products are there or some components are there, we cannot able to put recycle, or we cannot able to reduce them at the source site, at that time, sir, finally we will go for some disposal method. So this is just on your integrated waste management plan. Now see next question. Which one of the following is not greenhouse gases? So when you just we are talking about, sir, greenhouse gases are responsible for like our greenhouse effects are there. So when you just we are talking about, sir, our CO2 is there, our water vapor is there, also, sir, our this methane gas is also there. Also when you just we are talking about N2 is also there, our this CFC is also there, carbon, like this chlorofluorocarbons also there, SF6 also there. So different types of like greenhouse gases are there. So this water vapor is also there, carbon dioxide also there, methane is also there, and ethane. So this is not our greenhouse gases. So for this question, sir, answer is going to be D, because of not greenhouse gases. Now tell me, sir, which gas is just highest causing? Nearly 60% of like carbon dioxide is just responsible for our greenhouse gas. Now sir, nearly 20% responsible is just known as your methane. Okay, so these are like, whenever we are talking about, sir, maximum responsible gas for greenhouse gases is going to be carbon dioxide, then, sir, our methane. And also, whenever just we are talking about water vapor is also very important property, sir, because of whenever just we are talking about, sir, like in our environment, lots of water vapors are there, and this will absorb our incoming sun rays also and outgoing sun rays also. So this will create our double greenhouse gases effect. So this is also very important. So all three are part of our greenhouse gases. Ethane is not part. Also from sir remaining also like our this N2O is also part. Our chlorofluorocarbons also there. SF6, HFCs, all are the part of our greenhouse gases. So for this question, answer is going to be D. Now see next question. Environmental impact assessment in India is statutorily backed by which one of the following act? So whenever we are talking about sir, which act like our EIA is there, and sir, this EIA is nothing sir by UNEP, United Nations Environmental Program. They just given this definition. This is like a one type of tool to identify like environmental, our social and economic impact of project prior to like its decision of making. For example sir, in our planning stage or in also our design stage, we are just talking about sir what are going to be its environmental, its economic, its social impact of this project, and sir something like harmful is there, we are going to reduce it in our planning and designing stage. So this is just known as what, our EIA, environmental impact assessment. So basically whenever we are talking about sir, in India in 1986 we have created this Environmental Protection Act, and according to that sir, we have added our EIA, environmental impact assessment. So this is very important. EIA is a separate and very important. All the idea of EIA, in every year they just ask one or two questions from this EIA. So basic theory, what are the steps for this EIA, everything just we have discussed in our videos and not, so just refer those steps in proper manner. So sir, for this question just they are asking about which rule is there or which act sir. This is just known as the Environmental Protection Act 1986. Now see next question. Which one of the following correctly defined in terms of sustainable development? Sustainable word is very important sir. Whenever just we are talking about sustainable, we are using something, but we are using limitedly. We are putting something for our future generations also. For example sir, our coal is there, diesel is there, petrols are, or like petroleums are there. We are reducing and it is going to be like end one day. So that's why we are going for what? Green energy, sun energy, wind energy. So these are going to be like unlimited sources for our energy. So this is just known as what, sustainable things are there. So this is the meaning of our sustainable development. So the word definition of sustainable development means that the development which does not cause pollution, the development which meets need of present generation without compromising ability for future generation for meet their own needs. So this is going to be correct option. Means that we are using also, and for future generations also we are putting this, like those types of scheme or whatever just we are doing. This is just known as what, sustainable development. So answer B is going to be correct answer for this. So this completes some questions we have discussed here, and already from concept through questions. So already in last videos we have discussed like different types of question, basic videos, notes also available there. So this completes this subject, energy and environment. In next video we are going to discuss like number of questions from our basics of material science. So this completes this video. Thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you.